Well, there's a will, there's a way, kind of beautiful. And every night has a state so magical. And if there's love in this life, there's no obstacle that can't be defeated. For every tyrant to teal.
Welcome back. Today we're going to be talking about compound probability. So let's get started with that by taking a look at some things to remember. So we've got a few key things to remember. Remember, to find probability, we create a fraction of favorable outcomes over total outcomes. And independent probability is when we're talking about with replacement, and dependent probability is without replacement. Now let's look at this in a few scenarios. So here in situation A, it says Liam will pick two marbles. What is the probability that he will pick a striped marble and then a white marble? So we have two different scenarios. They want us to do it with replacement and without replacement. So in the first replacement, we got to look at how many striped marbles there are. So we can see that there are three striped marbles, so 3 out of 6. Then he's going to put it back. And how many white marbles are there? There's 1 out of 6. So we're going to have 3 out of 6 times 1 out of 6, which is going to equal 1/12. Then we've got to do it without replacement. So again, the first time we've got 3 out of 6 marbles are striped. But when we take one out and put it to the side, we do not replace it. We only have 5 marbles left in our container. So we've got 3 out of 6 for our stripe, then 1 out of 5, because remember we reduced the 1 marble by taking it out and not putting it back. So 3 times 1 is 3, 6 times 5 is 30, then 3 divided by 30 reduces to 1/10. So now we need to fill in our fraction and decimal so we can actually tell which one is the greater probability of happening. So we know our fraction for the first one is 1/12. If we turn that to a decimal by dividing our numerator by a denominator, we're going to have 0.083 repeating. Then our fraction for the second one is going to be 1/10, as we can see. And we're going to turn that to a decimal, and that's going to be 0.1 by, again, dividing the top by the bottom. So which one has a greater probability? Well, we can see that 0.1 is going to be greater than 0.0. So in this case, we're doing it without replacement is going to give us the better probability. Now let's take a look at situation B. So here in situation B, Whitney will pick 2 cards from the set to the right. What is the probability that she will pick a circle and then a heart? And again, we've got with replacement, without replacement. We've got to put fractions and decimals and decide which has a greater probability of happening. So Whitney's going to pick 2 cards. She's going to pick a circle and then a heart. So the first time we've got 4 out of 9 circles. Then we're going to put that right back. So we still have 9 cards in our set. And then how many of them are hearts? That's 3. When we do our math, 4 times 3 and 9 times 9, and we reduce it, we end up with 4/27 as our fraction. Now we're going to do the same thing without replacement. So the second time we're going to be taking a card away. So the first time we're going to have 4 out of 9, just like we did the first time. But this time we're going to have 3 out of 8 because we remove one of our circle cards, which we're going to do here by crossing it out just to see what would happen here. Cross out our circle. We can see that we only have 8 cards remaining. So we're going to do some multiplication. 4 times 3, 9 times 8. That's going to be 12 over 72, which we're going to reduce to 1/6. So now let's figure out which is more likely to happen. So we're going to start with our with replacement. Our fraction is 4/27, which we figured out when we did our math. That's going to give us a fraction of 0.1418, so on and so forth. And then we're going to do the same thing with our other side. So our fraction is 1/6, as we know. And we're going to turn that to a decimal, which is going to be 0.16. And the 6 is going to be repeating. So now we need to see which one has the greater probability. So we can see that both decimals start with 1, so that doesn't really help us. So we need to go to the hundreds place, the second hundreds place, or the hundreds place here. We can see that we've got a 4, and then we've got a 6. So the 6 is going to be greater than 4. So again, in this case, without is going to be our greater probability. Now let's look at a summary about what we just did. So in summary number 1 says, in situation A and B, which had a greater probability, with replacement or without? And then we've got to justify our answer. Well, we know in both scenarios we got without as our probability that was greater. Now we need to justify our answer. Well, the reason for this is when we were doing dependent probability, we reduced the total number of outcomes, but we did not reduce the amount of favorable outcomes. So both times we could get all the things that we wanted. We never removed any of the chances of things that we wanted to get, but we did reduce the number of things that we didn't want to get, right? We took away things that were not favorable to us. So that gave us a better chance because we took away things that weren't good for us to get. Now let's see what happens to us when we take away some of our favorable outcomes in situations C and D. So here we are in situation C, and it says Ross is going to pick 2 marbles, but what is the probability that both of them are black? So we're going to again do this with replacement and without, and then we're going to see which one has the greater probability of happening. So the first time that he's selecting two black marbles, so two out of the six marbles there, then he's going to put it back. So we're still going to have six marbles, and both of them are still going to be black that we're going to be choosing from. So 2 out of 6 times 2 out of 6 is going to give us 1/9. So now here comes the trick. We have to do this without replacement. So we're going to start by starting with our 2 6, because there are two marbles that have that are out of the six. But then we're going to remove one of the black marbles. So we're going to take it out of the scenario. So we're going to color it out here. So that's going to leave us with 1 black marble and only 5 black marbles total in our bag. So 2 out of 6 times 1 out of 5 is going to give us 1/15. So now we need to again compare. So our fraction for the first one is going to be 1/9. If we do that as a decimal, it's 0.1 repeating. Our second one, we're going to do a fraction. Again, we know our fraction is 1/15. We just found that. And now we're going to turn that as a decimal, so it's 0.06. So now we have to compare. So we can see that our 1 is greater than our 0, so this time with is more likely to happen. We removed our favorable number of outcomes for ourselves to change which one we picked. Now let's try situation D. So here in situation D, Tippian will pick 2 cards from the set below. What is the probability that she'll pick 2 hearts? So again, we're going to do this with replacement and without. So if we're looking over at our cards, we can see that 3 of them are hearts, and there are 9 total. So 3 out of 9, we're replacing it, 3 out of 9 again, and we reduce that to 1/3. Now we're going to do without replacement. So again, we've got 3 out of 9 to start with, but then we're going to remove one of our hearts, so we're going to cross it out, so we don't have that one anymore. And now we have 8 cards total, but only 2 of them are hearts. So again, the first time we started with 3 out of 9, but then we removed 1 total card, so our cards dipped from 9 to 8, and our total favorable outcomes dropped from 3 hearts to 2. So that left us with 1/12 when we multiplied everything together and did our reducing. So now we need to see which one is better. So our fraction is 1/3 to begin with, and that decimal, hopefully we all know, is 0.3 repeating. Our fraction for the next one is going to be 1/12. And then if we turn that to a decimal, we're going to get 0.083. So now it's time to do some comparing. So we can see that our 3 is much larger than our 0. So in this case, again, with is going to be the thing that has the greater probability of happening. So let's sum this up now. So in situation 2, or summary 2, in situation C and D, which had a greater probability with replacement or without replacement? So as we did both of our scenarios, we found that with was the one that had a greater probability. And the reason for this and our justification is we reduced the total number of outcomes and the number of favorable outcomes. So that was different than our first two scenarios. First two scenarios removed outcomes, but they were things we didn't want. So therefore, it was better for us in the with because we get to keep all of our favorable outcomes, but get rid of the outcomes we didn't want. In summary number 2, we got rid of favorable outcomes, which ended up being bad for us because we want to have as many chances to get the thing that we want in order for that probability to be greater. That brings us to the end of this set of notes. It also brings us to the end of this video. So if you like this video, go ahead and throw us a thumbs up. If you love this video, go ahead and throw us a sub, and we will catch you in the next one. And if we lost all the bones,